brand in healthy lifestyle products.
Oh, and look at it right away. Soo Chul Kim goes right at BB.
And both furious exchange as they get up.
Soo Chul Kim doing a good job of stuffing those shots.
Whoa! Thunderous blow from Bibiano.
Bibiano's in on a single leg here. That was a good exchange to start it.
Soo Chul Kim showing that he is going to stand his ground and throw leather with at least the intensity of the Brazilian.
Well, this is BB's world now. And Bibiano said that, I don't want to go to a decision with Soo Chul Kim. I want to make a statement here. I want to stop him. And this is all Bibiano's world. Soo Chul Kim has a wrestling background, but his accolades are definitely more in the explosion and crazy fighting style.
Bibiano taking quite a few blows to the face there. He gave a few back, but...
Yeah, those shots really don't do much, though. They look good for the judges. You're not creating a whole lot of force with 4-ounce gloves from a foot away. You're going to see Bibiano try to pass here and get his left leg free and try to improve position.
Almost in the ring with you there.
And I got to think that Soo Chul Kim's best chance of coming away with a W here is probably standing up on his feet against BB. So, you know, stalling out here may not be a bad thing if the referee does stand these guys up. BB's trying to work in, it looks like, on a head and arm choke. He's got it in pretty tight on that far side. He's going to have to open his legs, and he's going to jump to the right side of Soo Chul Kim, our left side.
Kim has done a pretty good job of tying up Bibiano's legs.
He's going to hop over now. He's in the mount. It looks like that head and arm choke might be in pretty deep. It applies the same type of pressure as a triangle choke.
Kim, here's the check. Yuji Shimada asking the question, are you okay?
Yeah, you can see he's still conscious.
Keep going. Off to finish.
BB may try to hop over to the side or just be happy keeping the position. Just abandoned the choke.
Taking a knee to the head there, Bibiano. Just missed with that one. It's the right knee of Soo Chul Kim that's launching the attack. There it is again. Again, it only grazed. Couldn't quite get close enough to land a deep blow.
Well, you know, every time you throw a punch, whether you're on the top or the bottom, you're giving your opponent space to maneuver, so you have to be very conscious of how you're moving. Vivi's looking to mount here again, pushing down the legs.
They're 10 feet away from us here at cage side, and it's tiring just watching. The
nice
blow
right
came
hand.
Down from Bibi. He's not bothered about those. Probably more tiring than it is punishing. Up you get, says Yuji Shimada.
This is, I think, where Soo Chul Kim is going to explode again here.
Let's see what he does. Looking for the right hand. He's setting it up with a little left.
Nice.
Bibi's strong, such a tough upper body he's got.
Doing very well. You're winning this round, you're winning the fight.
Big pair of arms.
Soo Chul Kim is very comfortable in the clinch here. He's had a lot of work against a high level black belt. And he fought Leandro Issa.
Stamping on the foot there.
Oh, Bibi just misses with that right hook.
10 seconds, 10 seconds.
First round, pretty much in the books. Final 5 seconds.
Okay,
five low. He threw that straight hand. I didn't expect Suchul Kim to shoot in on Bibi.
Bibiano's quick, and that was a good right-left combination.
Look for that takedown, and when you get it, control position. Not control. Relax a little bit. Kim, make him work. You relax.
Even if Kim does trade with this Brazilian, he's so strong, and he's got speedy hands.
Yeah, he's speedy.
It's hard to see where his weakness is.
Well, I think that his weakness is his strength, right? I mean, if you look at it, Bibiano's, his strength is clearly he wants to get you to the ground and exploit the jiu-jitsu. So I think that the weakness is that opponents are going to know that that's primarily what his game plan is. So right. It's a little easier to kind of focus around that as opposed to a guy that's has wins by knocking guys out with spinning back fist and can take you down. And that's not to say that Bibi's not a great striker. It's just that he tends to gravitate towards the thing that he's the best at. And it's done really well for him.
You might have noticed that Suchul Kim has a small mark high up on his cheek there, of no consequence so far, but we'll keep an eye on that.
Well, Bibiano's a grinder. I mean, his last two fights in ONE FC, he won by decision, but he was constantly working the whole time. And you have guys that are very high level. Sometimes it looks like it mutes itself out, and you ask yourself, how come someone's not going for something, or why aren't they looking for a submission? And that's just because you give someone that 2 inches at this high a level, and you give up your position, and you really risk the whole fight. So smart and methodical is oftentimes the best strategy.
Tremendous core strength from Suchul Kim there, who looks to be marked above the left eye as well. You can see a lump there, and that could open up. The skin gets tight when there's a swelling and makes it easier to cut.
Yeah, Yuji Shimada calling for some more action. You're staying busy, but you have to also look to improve your position. Otherwise, they're going to get stood back up here. I think that Yuji may step in if this isn't. There we go. And this really gives Suchul Kim his best opportunity, in my opinion. He throws a lot of punches. He's not afraid to sit in the pocket there. And he's been able to stuff a couple of good shots. Oh, nice left hand by Bibi.
Missed with a huge overhand right.
You notice how Suchul Kim, he steps in on his punches too. He really puts his weight behind it. He's committed to those punches. He knows he might take a shot, but he's going to give you the harder one.
Bibi really does seem to have a big, powerful right hand that if he can land it solidly, could just end the night.
You hear the smack of leather
throwing
cage side.
At the same time.
And another nice stuff there by Suchul Kim.
Knee from Bibi was high up on the inside of Suchul Kim's thigh. Pretty close to being a foul blow.
We've seen enough of those for one night.
I think we have.
We got to find out what the record is for cup shots in one night. What, 3 or 4? Really a game of chess in the clinch there. You have to work for inside position. You see Bibi's working his hands inside. Both guys are fighting for wrist control. And I give all the credit in the world to Yuji Shimada. He is really on top of that with keeping the action going.
It's always appreciated in Singapore. It's almost always met with a round of applause.
Suchul Kim is really keeping his eyes on Bibi's waist. He's trying to see when Bibi's dropping to shoot that shot. He has been able to stuff, I think, about half of the shots so far, which is a pretty good. And another one he stuffed.
Big heavy blows.
Punches. Yep.
Entering the final half minute, a slapping kick to the outside of Kim's left thigh.
Nice takedown by Bibi.
Just an exhausting two rounds this has been, and there's three more to come. Three more, right, Jason?
Three more, yes. Three.
That's right, that time.
This is one, and we saw one. You want to lend me $20? I'm
gonna give you a real two-way conversation going on in Bibi's corner as well, wasn't it? He was asking questions and getting clarification. Good communication in that corner. Meanwhile, the action is furious again in the third.
Another nice takedown.
so busy on top, Viviano there.
It really is like carving from a brick of stone when you're on top of a guy like that. Those, the big shots are like dynamite going off, and the little shots from your waist there, those just chipping away. But every time you're chipping away, you're making a picture, and you're making that opponent more sore.
Viviano took a brutal up kick to the jaw, and he just brushed it off. He then took some to that hard torso of him. There's no effect whatsoever.
Suchul Kim just really throws just odd angles. He doesn't just come in like with one, two, or swinging punches. He's throwing uppercut elbows and looping legs.
Isn't he?
Yeah, it's crazy. I mean, that's why he has such success. He's hard to train for a guy that throws haymakers constantly. And he has a very solid, underrated wrestling base, as you can see. I mean, a guy like Bibiano, if you're not a great grappler, he's going to take you down whenever he wants to take you down. And Suchul Kim has probably stopped 50, 60% of the takedowns so far. Sweat and the natural attrition of the fight wear in, too. That percentage, I think, is going to shoot up.
As they pulled apart, Bibi landed a very nice right hand to the jaw.
A lot of people thought that this was going to be a fairly easy fight for Bibiano, and I kept telling everybody, man, you cannot count Suchul Kim out. Like, do you realize you're counting out the guy that won the belt? He is the actual bantamweight champion, and he's fought guys that everybody thought this guy's not going to really have a chance, but, you know, call it the Cinderella story of MMA. Oh, beautiful takedown! He's been very successful in this one FC cage. And it's fun to watch him fight, too. He just loves fighting, and he's 21. He's going to get so much better.
It's hard to believe his age, isn't he? With the receding hairline and all, he just doesn't look at it. With his record, you just don't get the feeling of a 21-year-old right in front of you. Incidentally, the violence with which they come together is quite shocking at the close distances that our cameras are able to give you.
Well, we're halfway through this championship bout. So far, I think, you know, it's got to be Bibi just winning on the takedowns. But, oh, Suchul Kim now with a nice takedown and a nice knee to follow up.
Just managed to get out of the way of that huge overhand right that I've pinpointed before from Bibiano Fernandez. He does have good evasive head movement, the Korean. Cuffing little left hook inside from Kim. Eats through little chopping uppercuts from Bibiano.
Yeah, Suchul Kim, I think, is really trying to turn the pace here in this fight. He had a couple of nice takedown attempts on Bibi. Pressed the pace into Bibi's face. Throwing some nice leather.
Oh, there's that overhand right I've been talking about. Sure that we've seen so much of that from Fernandez before. And as I've said, if he can land flush with it, it could be all over. Problem is, it comes from so far back, there's an element of it being telegraphed. And as we've said, Kim has good evasive maneuvers.
Nice hip control. Oh, Bibi looks like he has a cut over his right eye now. He does, he definitely has a little cut over his right eye. Doesn't look like it's much, but I think one of those initial elbows in that exchange on taking him down may have caused that.
Suchul Kim hooking his toes on the cage and being pulled off by
he's
the
halfway to out. Yeah, there you go, all the way out now. Really nice work by Suchul Kim, avoiding the grappling prowess of Bibiano Fernandez. You know, when records don't really tell the whole story in MMA, unlike boxing or things like that, where a guy can be 50-2. In mixed martial arts, you wouldn't think a guy that's the former dream featherweight, dream bantamweight champion would be going into the championship round down the pipe.
Left, right, left, right, left, right from Suchul Kim.
You know, it gets really frustrating, too, when you're having a hard time passing a guy's guard. You're getting takedown after takedown. He just Suchil Kim staying very, very active.
We've seen this before.
Good up kick.
Bibiano hasn't been so keen to get involved when we're in this position previously. He's thinking about it.
Bibiano wants to lead with his hip and his foot, not his face, because he can get kicked really bad with an up kick there. If Suchil Kim starts kicking low and Bibi feels comfortable leaning forward, and then he throws one right up to his head.
Now, picking up on something you said before, I was watching when they were standing up just now. Suchil Kim focuses on Bibiano's waist. He's always looking down.
Well, I think that's smart because that's where his center of gravity is. And guys can fake you out with their hands and with their head movement, but your waist doesn't lie. Where you can't shoot if your hips are up high. You can't throw punches if you're not turning over your hips as well. So, nice over-the-top elbow.
Good right hand. Was it an elbow? Yes.
Yeah, it was an elbow. Yeah, right over the top. It was a slapping elbow. Nice spinning back kick by Suchil Kim.
Ooh's and ahs from the Singapore Indoor Stadium crowd. It's a packed house here, and they are absorbed. Oh, good left hand to Bibiano's gut there.
Oh, big, nice takedown by Suchil Kim. Boy, Suchil Kim just really, really impressing me in his last three 1FC fights.
Oh! This is the reverse of what we've seen a few times.
I was a little confused by that. It looked like he waved him up, then bowed, then moved in to kick him. Okay, go! Yuji Shimada keeping this at a turbo pace.
2 minutes left of the fourth.
No mercy
rest for the wicked, is there, Yuji's refereeing.
God bless, man. I love Yuji as a ref. I'm a fan of his when he was refing Pride. This guy's been in there for some of the craziest fights in the history of mankind. Both fighters are showing a lot of respect for each other, both for their power, for their takedown ability.
1:30 left in the fourth round. These are the championship rounds. Unification bout in the bantamweight division. Bibiano Fernandez holds the interim belt. Suchil Kim is the bantamweight champion. The winner here takes it all.
You know, one of the things, too, I think that's important to note is that Suchil Kim has been out for months due to surgery. He had shoulder surgery, and a lot of times guys come back from a surgery and the question of ring rust, you know, how are you going to perform having not been in there and not been in that pace and tempo of constantly training, especially when you're coming back against a guy like Bibiano Fernandez, who's the toughest test of your career. And man, Suchil Kim has just looked absolutely spectacular thus far.
Just took a solid right hand, a short right hand from Bibiano. Excellent chin the Korean has. Both of these men take a punch very well.
Bibiano getting good wrist control and keeping nice pressure.
Beckons the crowd to get involved, then looks at his watch, which of course he's not wearing. Spins Bibiano around and then attacks the body. What a character.
Oh, and he gets a nice little inside leg sweep again. He had success with that the first time with Bibiano. I think Bibiano's had more success with takedowns and he's pushed it more with engaging, but this is a tough fight to call. I think I'd give it to Bibiano by a hair at this point. Oh, a nice 3-2 down the pipe. Bibiano's got that left hand a little low. Taking a page out of Roy Jones Jr.'s book. Suchil Kim and Bibi both, their cardio looks incredible. This may be a record now.
I think we're in new territory.
Joint shot. I'm buying all these guys cups. Everybody. That's crazy.
Must be something in the air.
Yeah, flying knees.
Bibiano takes the opportunity to squat down and have a bit of a break. Suchil Kim doesn't use anything like the 5 minutes that he could. And Bibiano gets a bit of a verbal warning from Yuji Shimada. Next time, yellow card, he said. Oh,
Viviano is one of the nicest guys that I think I've met in MMA.
Yeah.
I would testify on oath that guy would never throw a knee on purpose to another fighter.
With you on that.
Some dirty boxing here.
Left hand from Suchil Kim. It's all pretty desperate stuff now. This is the round that could decide it. Bibiano probably slightly ahead, but...
Oh, I don't know anymore, man. I think that Bibiano was ahead the first few rounds, and I think that Suchil Kim is ahead now. About 2:30 left to figure this out here.
The point is, it's all to play for, yeah, with 2.5 minutes left.
100%. One strong minute from either guy, I think, could really clinch this in the judges' eyes. I mean, if you take a look at this, right, if you're at home, you see Bibiano got the takedowns early. Not a ton of discernible damage. But the aggression, I think that standing up, I have to give that to Suchil Kim. Grappling control, I've got to give to Bibiano. There weren't a lot of submission attempts to speak of. And you know, how much do we really give credence to takedown attempts that miss? You know, is another thing to factor in. So, but Bibiano has been a little more aggressive in pushing the fight with the takedowns and dictating where that fight takes place.
Kim seems to make it his young life's work to surprise people, to upset them. A lot of people thought this was Bibby's for the taking in a bit of a pedestrian manner. Not so. Bibby got clipped with a right hand there as they broke. 1 minute and 15 seconds remaining. Championship belts on the line. And this is a real trial for Bibiano. He got abused for attacking the single leg there. And Suchil Kim.
Suchil Kim has been the Cinderella story. Just with upset after upset after upset.
Endless cardio, both men, to be fair.
I mean, I don't know if Suchil Kim has done enough to warrant the victory. Looking at overall damage and things, though, this is going to be interesting to see how this gets scored. It's fights like this that I don't want to judge, because you look at the first 12 minutes of this fight, and it's a completely different fight than the last 12 minutes. A nice stuff by Bibi.
Final 20 seconds. Again, Bibi goes for the takedown. Single leg again, and again he gets punished.
Now, if he can finish a takedown here, that may be the last thing the judges remember, is this last 10 seconds.
It could be something like that that could just tip it one way or the other. Desperate stuff now for both men, and it's all over. Suchil Kim is very unhappy.
Oh, I think he's happy. I don't think he's unhappy.
Well, I don't know. That's not an easy emotion to read there. Is making his way into the cage.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards. And all three judges see it for the winner via unanimous decision. And now, the undisputed 1FC Bantamweight World Champion from the blue corner, Bibiano, the Flesh Fernandez.